Ago, it was the Steelers and Cowboys, and the names are legend. Pittsburgh's acrobatic receiver Lynn Swann, an MVP winner. Quarterback Terry Bradshaw then passed his team to a second victory over Dallas. But more important than who won is the character of the men that took the field in those games, men that continue to distinguish themselves. Franco Harris, as a player, he hammered defenses. Today, as a prominent businessman, he watches his modern counterpart, Emmitt Smith. He dominates the way Franco did. As you admire quarterback Troy Aikman's leadership and courage, you can't help but recall Cowboy great Roger Staubach, now a highly successful CEO. Receiver Lynn Swann captivated crowds with his spectacular ballet-style catches. Now a sports commentator, today he'll marvel at another number 88 explosive, Michael Irvin. Cringe as Pittsburgh's linebacker Greg Lloyd targets the enemy. In the 70s, it was relentless Randy White. Today, he cowboys at his own wrench. All-pro Carnell Lake volunteered a new position to fill a void left by injury. His selflessness brings to mind the Cowboys' Charlie Waters, now a coach at Oregon. As the times have changed, so have coaches. The stoic Tom Landry, a contrast to today's emotional Bill Cowher. The evolution brings flamboyant, multi-talented performers like Deion Sanders and Pittsburgh Steelers quarterback slash receiver Cordell Stewart. Today, we cheer a new generation, acknowledging, appreciating the talent of men destined to become tomorrow's heroes. Today, legends will be built in Super Bowl 30. Valley of the sun and shadows falling on a 70 degree day. The fortunate few 76,000 fans to see Super Bowl 30. The Steelers and the Cowboys meet again in the big game. Hello everyone, Dick Enberg along with Phil Sims and Paul McGuire. We're delighted that you're with us. Here are the mathematics. Super Bowl 30. Millions will watch around the world, including our men in uniform and women in uniform in Bosnia, and we hope you enjoy the game today. And yet, less than 100 men will decide the outcome of this game, and the winners will join San Francisco, winning a record 5 Super Bowls. A man who has been down in the tunnel, awaiting his name to be introduced at the start of a Super Bowl, Phil Sims, take us there.
Well, Dick, I tell you what it's all about. It's about tension early in the football game. As a player, you always dream, what's it going to be like to stand in that tunnel? Well, times it by 10, and then you have it. And a story that illustrates that, in our third play of the game in 1987 in the Super Bowl, I go in the huddle, I look at all my teammates, their hands are on their knees, they're hyperventilating. That made me nervous. We go to the line of scrimmage, I look over at the defense, their hands are on their knees, they're hyperventilating too. I tell you what, I felt a lot better after that.
Now, there is a common denominator. Ron Earhart was your offensive coordinator. He'll be calling the plays for Neil O'Donnell today.
Tremendous plus for Neil O'Donnell. Ron Earhart's been there. The good thing he did with me, he got me off to a good start. He has to do that with Neil O'Donnell. Get a couple easy completions, make him think positive thoughts. He'll play better, and I think that's important for Pittsburgh to have a chance to win.
Well, make no doubt about it, this is a Super Bowl fight, and the heavy favorites are the Cowboys by 2 touchdowns.
Well, this is like a barroom brawl for the Pittsburgh Steelers. You know, if you've ever been in one, you see the toughest guy in the room, and he picks you out, and you know he has a reputation. You don't dance with this guy. You go up and smack him in the mouth. And that's what they have to do offensively and defensively to the Dallas Cowboys. You know, when you sit there and look at it, they think they have their offense down. I don't think so. The Pittsburgh Steelers have some other things in there. Defensively, Dallas thinks they have all the blitzes down. You don't, because they put some more in. And I talked to Ron Earhart, the offensive coordinator of the Pittsburgh Steelers, the other day, and I said, you know, you were on Super Bowl teams. What is the best team we ever coached? He says, this is it. Better than any of those. And I'll tell you why. Because if you tell these guys that they can't do something, they're going to do it.
Well, everyone has an opinion of how and when and where this game will be decided. We asked one of the stars of Super Bowl 30, at least projected to be one, Deion Sanders. Primetime said, the key today is if I catch 2 passes, one on offense and one on defense, the Cowboys, as projected, will win again.
Let's meet the National Football Conference champion, Dallas Cowboys. Sonoma State, number 73, Larry Allen. And right tackle from Central State, Ohio, number 79, Eric Williams. And tight end from Wyoming, number 84, Jay Novacek. And wide receiver from Miami, number 88, Michael Urban. At fullback from Syracuse, number 48, Daryl Johnston. At running back from Florida, number 22, Emmitt Smith. from UCLA, number 8, Troy Aikman. And the head coach of the Cowboys, Barry Switzer. Defensive starters. At left end from Clemson, number 96, Brinson Buckner. At right tackle from Colorado, number 93, Joel Steed. At right end, number 97, Ray Steed. Outside linebacker from Auburn, number 91, Kevin Green. At left inside linebacker from Clemson, number 99, LaVon Kirkland. At right inside linebacker from Colorado, number 94, Chad Brown. At right outside linebacker from Fort Valley State, number 95, Greg Lloyd. Left cornerback from UCLA, number 37, Carnell Lake.
Let's go.
At right cornerback from Western Carolina, number 27, Willie Williams. At free safety from Penn State, number 39, Darren Perry. At strong safety from Michigan State, number 40, Myron Bell. And the head coach of the Steelers, Bill Cowher. And now, to honor America, please join nine-time Grammy nominee Vanessa Williams in the singing of our national anthem. Today, we also pay tribute to the valiant crew of the Space Shuttle Challenger, who 10 years ago gave their lives in the development of new frontiers. The anthem will be followed by a flyover of F-16 jets from the 78th Fighter Squadron at Shaw Air Force Base. The missing man will be flown by Captain Rich Scobie, son of Challenger Mission Commander Dick Scobie.
So proudly we hailed at but the twilight's last gleam. Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, all the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Valuable players from previous Super Bowl games are now on the field and will take part in today's coin toss ceremony. As we celebrate the 30th anniversary of the Super Bowl, please welcome these great stars who have played such an integral part in the tradition of the NFL's World Championship game. Coming to midfield for the coin toss ceremony are Cowboy captains Mark Tuinay, Troy Aikman, Michael Irvin, David Lang, Darren Woodson, and Tony Tolbert. Representing the Steelers are captains LeVon Kirkland, Kevin Green, Dermonte Dawson, John L. Williams, and Fred McAfee.
We'll step off if you take your team right around this direction, please.
The referee for today's game is Red Cashin. And representing the most valuable players to toss the coin is three-time Super Bowl MVP quarterback Joe Montana.
Captains, our coin today for the toss is this commemorative coin honoring the Super Bowl 30. The logo for Super Bowl 30 will be tails. The two helmets will be heads. Tossing the coin will be Super Bowl MVP Joe Montana. Captain Aikman, please call the toss while Joe throws it in the air.
Tails.
Tails is called. See, which end will you kick from? Cowboys won the toss, chose to receive. Gentlemen, let's play football.
The Cowboys, the favorites, will get the ball first. And Barry Switzer's Dallas team, a long delay. It's like clockwork during the regular NFL season. The introduction of starting lineups usually to the second. But there were minutes of delay before Dallas finally wandered out of the locker room for their introductions. And one has to wonder if there was some gamesmanship there keeping the Steelers in their own locker room.
You're a cheating You'll cry and cry
and try to sleep, but sleep won't come. Will tell you when tears come down like falling rain. You'll toss around.
What a hit by Wendy White!
Eddie George, Heisman Trophy winner, you got a big future ahead of you, kid.
Reggie White?
You're gonna be asked to endorse products.
You should contact the people who make Tylenol.
Neil Smith?
Extra strength, because you could be on intimate terms with Tylenol.
Ken Norton Jr.
From headaches to broken bones, doctors recommend Tylenol the most.
Oh, and Eddie, it's the pain reliever hospitals use most.
Hospitals?
Hospitals.
Plymouth Neon. Fun and affordability in four-door and coupe. The all-new Plymouth Voyager and Grand Voyager, the next generation of the minivan. And the new Plymouth Breeze, the sports sedan with fun for five. The new line of Plymouths, what'll they come up with next?
Troy Aikman and that huge offensive line take the field. Aikman's previous two Super Bowls producing solid numbers, over 70% completion rate, a record for the Super Bowl, and very few errors by this strong-arm quarterback who was recruited by Barry Switzer to Oklahoma, played a year there, and then eventually transferred to UCLA. Became a part of a terrific finish by this Pittsburgh team. Second and 10. The quick throw to Irvin, Michael Irvin, and he's all the way to the 50-yard line. Willie Williams trips him up. And Michael Irvin saying, I barely saw the ball, looking back into the setting sun.
Well, that sun is directly in his eyes. Now, you look on the outside, you see Willie Williams covering. Look how far he gives inside. There is nobody inside to take the play. Michael Irvin, he just...
First appearance offensively, split to the left. And Emmitt Smith's first carry. 9-10. He's all the way to the 28-yard line.
Talking about the size of the Cowboy line. Watch Larry Allen come over here and create the hole for Emmitt Smith. Larry Allen, a big man, just knocks Greg Lloyd right out of the hole, and the safety, Myron Bell, is not up inside to make the tackle.
Second down and 8. Aikman to Irvin, incomplete, hit by Lake. Irvin had it for a moment at the 10-yard line. Story, and Deion Sanders is in. It's a reverse to Williams, and he's tripped up as he crosses the 25, shy of a first down. It appeared that Chad Brown might have gotten a hand on him.
The one thing that surprised me right now is
42-yard attempt by Chris Bonyol, who missed only one all year. It's high enough, it's long enough, it is good. The Cowboys put the first dent in the Super Bowl scoreboard, 3-0. In the Buttes in Tempe, Arizona, Sun Devil Stadium. Team scoring first, goes on to win all but 8 Super Bowl games, and Barry Switzer's team has the 3-0 lead.
Conservative runs, I don't understand it. And besides, you've got the defense looking back into the sun.
It's a long way to go, so I don't know if I'd call it conservative yet.
They go with the 5 wideouts, the revolutionary offensive formation of the Steelers this year, with Cordell Stewart slot left. O'Donnell third and a long 6. A lot of time. The catch is made shy of the yardsticks by Andre Hastings, their big third down receiver. It'll be 4th and 1.
You know what I like, Dick, as I watch this? Look at gentlemen they are. They eat with their mouths closed.
Yeah.
Nice.
350 is Derry Kennard. Big old Larry Allen, pretty close at 330, and Eric Williams at 330. So the average is 333 pounds per man.
Is it more, Phil?
Is it? Woodson is in, and so is Deion Sanders. In fact, Woodson matched against Sanders on the near sidelines. Aikman slips and still hits Michael Irvin. First down at the 39. Darnell Lake, another tackle for Pittsburgh.
Up and watch Troy Aikman. Composure, been here before. He slips, he gets up, he knows Michael Irvin is on Darnell Lake, does a good job of leading him.
In the same season. Sanders still in as Aikman on first down. Goes long for Sanders. Caught by Dion at the 15-yard line.
Well, Paul, Willie Williams was in perfect position on his jump or his move to the football on time. Right here, he's on the outside technique. He's really hoping to get some help deep, but the Cowboys do a good job of getting the safety out of the middle. And right there, he's just a little too quick and jumping Dion. Excellent job of catching the football.
A little afterwards, I'll dance a little bit.
Little prime time, 47 yards on the play.
Back, and he threw the ball, I guess, 140 yards downfield. Yeah. But he threw it, he said, I thought I out threw Sanders. And he said, then he ran and he caught the ball. The thing that surprised him was when we went back to look at the practice on film, he realized that he threw it as far as he could, and Dion had to slow down when he got there.
Sack. Well, 55, Paul McGuire's old number. The Cowboys inside the 20. Look at that hip movement of McGuire.
Watch this, boys. Watch it, boys. Now watch it.
Oh, that's not right. That ain't right.
What do you mean it's not right?
That's all. There's no way you have that much rhythm.
And here's a big third and nine. Leading 3-0. First and goal, I believe. It's inside the three. Flag down. But it's on the side from the linesman where Kevin Green jumped early. Darrell Johnston, the blocking back, fake to Smith. Wide open, Novacek, touchdown, Dallas. Check, who grew up cutting horses in Gothenburg, Nebraska, was a University of Wyoming Cowboy, and now in his 11th year in the league, although he started here with the Cardinals, now a Cowboy with that big blue star, and he's getting
so wide open. He's up top here. Watch, he's going to come all the way across in here, but watch Kendall Watkins go inside and pick off number 55, Jerry Osofsky, on a pick play. Play action. Here comes Jay Novacek, comes across. See the pick inside? That's why he was wide open for the touchdown.
Illegal. Wide open. Ernie Mills and a first down at the 39. 10 yards, the first down for the Steelers. Back behind O'Donnell. From the 40, it's Morris plowing his way for 6 yards.
Big boy coming in. Big boy.
Robert Jones and others to make the tackle. Mills in motion and a toss to Stewart. And battle as he may, he's brought down at the 49. It's going to be very close to a first down. Larry Brown came up from the corner, 24, to help out on the tackle. Mother watching back in the same house where he said, I used to watch the Super Bowl with my dad in the living room. I know right where he's sitting today, watching every play. And O'Donnell way out to the right. First down to the 49 of the Cowboys.
I mean, it's just a quarterback sneak, Dick, but I tell you what, good patience by Cordell Stewart, seeing where the defensive tackles were. Season around.
Third down, 8. 10th play of this drive. O'Donnell drills it for a first down. Andre Hastings.
I'm going to tell you one thing.
Oh, a fumble by O'Donnell and the no-huddle offense. They tried to come out on first down, no huddle, and it cost them big yardage. 13, the deficit on the miscue.
Here, the ball just slips out of Dermonte Dawson's hands and goes straight up. Excellent job, though, by Neil O'Donnell getting down on it.
That's a kind Paul McGuire would call a fair catch.
I mean, that's got to be scary. You know, you're in the...
What is it about centers? Derek Kennard has the same problem for Dallas. Five wide, spread the field. O'Donnell, good protection. Caught on the near sidelines by Corey Holiday at the 39-yard line. Holiday did not have a reception in the regular season. He's from North Carolina. Field goal and a 3-yard touchdown, Aikman to Novacek.
The best way to introduce the new Plymouth Breeze is by applying the lessons you learned in kindergarten. Take turns. share with others. Follow the rules of safety. And oh yeah, get something really cool to bring to show and tell. The new Plymouth Breeze.
And triplicate, have a seat over there.
Who's next?
Well, something happened here. What it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a gun over there. He's telling me I've got to beware. I think it's time we stop shooting what got down. Everybody look what's going down. Stop.
Master, padlocks and door locks are no longer held under fire. Nike presents Pee Wee Football, the year in review. Needing a first down to keep their playoff hopes alive, the Tigers look to Paul the Flash Terstige. Like any great back, number seven stares into the eyes of his pursuers and something of himself is revealed. Number seven is a number with wings. But on the game's pivotal drive, Terstige was dealt a season's worth of punishment in a single play.
For the Oscar Mayer Halftime Show.
Formation, Hastings into the backfield to pick up a blitzer. He didn't, but Miles can't catch O'Donnell and throws. Intercepted by Larry Brown. Very similar to Brown's move against Brett Favre in the NFC Championship game to intercept along the sidelines to end Green Bay's final bid for the lead.
But what happens here? Godfrey Miles right here behind these three linemen. The Steelers do not account for it. Look, and they get right there. Nobody's there to block Godfrey Miles. Neil O'Donnell does a good job of getting out.
You know what I don't understand is Andre Hastings in the backfield. Why he didn't block him? He runs by Miles. He never even takes a look at him. That's his man.
Deion Sanders, first return 11 yards. He's back at the 10. Ron Stark's punt. Sanders lets it go. And it's in the end zone for the touchback, a net 19 yards on the punt for the veteran star. We come back. Dallas will be at the 20. They've scored on their first two, and Aikman comes out throwing. Over the middle, complete to Novacek. A gain of about four. Third catch for Novacek, one of those for a touchdown. Remember a couple, 3 years ago, his mother collected aluminum cans all year long, hoping the Cowboys would go to the Super Bowl so she'd pay her own way. She didn't want her son to take care of her. So
she should have hung around Paul.
My wife just used my credit card.
Second down, over the middle, Novacek wide open again, and he rolls ahead for two more yards, and a first down at the 38. This day where there's a lot of me-ism, he said, hey, for my team, I'll play corner. Aikman on second and 10. Oh, the big target, Michael Irvin, he just shields the defenders away. Another first down at the 50.
Time to throw it outside, single coverage.
Well, here's where Irvin, he just blocks out. He blocks the sun out. Carnelli has no chance on the ball. But look where the ball was thrown. Down to the outside where you can't get to it.
First down. And Emmett Smith picks up five. Slithering through the center of the Dallas line. And the five. Smith with a flag down. A gain of four more.
to the 41. Let's see if it counts.
Defensive linemen, you know they're all 330 and better. I mean, that's the average, 333 offside the defense.
Yeah, I like those darkness runners to block for.
In other words, he doesn't run up the rear end to the offensive line.
Moose Johnson, Darryl Johnson, the popular blocking back, gets rare chances to carry the ball, picks up the first down on second and short.
All right, Phil, I'm going to tell you now.
Aikman to Johnston, and the fullback is drilled at the 28-yard line. Might be shy of the first down, depending on the mark. Myron Bell, second-year safety from Michigan State with a solid hit.
They've got to get the ball to just inside the 27-yard
line. He's about 280. Ron Stone, over 300 pounds. They come in to bookend the line, so now we've got over a ton of beef in that white uniform Cowboy offensive line.
I got to say it.
First down at the 24. The Moose brings out his callers. Drive their third possession. Looking long, Aikman deep. Touchdown, Michael Irvin, as he brought a flag down. Carnell Lake was the defender, and they're saying Irvin got away with a push. No, flags are down.
I'll tell you, the other guy that was wide open was Jay Novacek. I mean, there was no one, absolutely no one. You know, when they publicized Irvin, Phil, all year long about him pushing off, and we asked Red Cashin in the meeting the other day.
Down the field, it's going to be the post. He's going to go inside. Carnell Lake, oh, excellent job of staying patient. Cuts off the throwing lane. Michael Irvin grabs his right hand, puts it on his shoulder, and pulls him down.
Good call. Excellent call.
One of the few mistakes by the Cowboys in this first half. Over the middle, Novacek open again. And he's all the way to the 15-yard line. A gain of 19 before Greg Lloyd can chase him down.
Well, you know,
I mean, he had a very small window, and he put it in the right pane. First down, second down and one. And Emmett Smith gained about a yard. It'll be close to a first down at the 14. About a half yard. The toss to Emmett.
Boy, to me, now, I can't believe that this play was designed to go outside. I believe that it was designed to go to the inside, but they
try out of Novacek's hold. It'll be a 35-yard attempt. And it is good. Three possessions for Dallas, two field goals, and a touchdown. Ray Hastings at the 42 of Pittsburgh. First punt for John Jett. And he sends up beauty. Perfect spiral. Hastings at the 35. That's two blocks. Three. Runs into his own man. And down he goes near the 50-yard line. Willie Williams actually made the hit on Andre Hastings. 4 for 10 in this opening half. Texan breaks down, and Charles Haley has his first sack today.
Let me just say one thing before you describe all this stuff, Phil. The reason this sack comes because of the great coverage downfield. This is a coverage sack.
Seeing their first Super Bowl game from Glass, Virginia. Third and 20 for O'Donnell. Underneath, he goes to Hastings with some running room, and Hastings fights close to a first down. He's at the 44. It appears he's just shy.
It's four down territory. You've got 3 minutes to go. You've got to score. You've got to at least get on the board. They've got about a half a yard for a first down.
For a first down, and he's under center again.
Go right, Cordell. Go right.
He does. First down, Pittsburgh.
Well, the whole big opening is on the right-hand side.
It's computer age. You can punch up some pretty impressive numbers for Slash. As a quarterback, he's 5 for 7. As a running back, average 5.7 and 14 catches. And he's even punted once for 41 yards. O'Donnell going long for Thigpen. Incomplete.
Now I'll tell you what, here's where you can have some offensive pass interference on Thigpen. And then
second and 10, Van Horst. Big man rumbles, first down at the 30 with 2:06. And ticking away, we come to the two-minute timeout. Pittsburgh's best chance to score, and the Steelers' terrible towels are out. third and seven. They go to the five wide with John L. Williams in the backfield. Throw complete, but short of the first down. Ernie Mills hit right at the 20-yard line, did not penetrate, which would be required for the first down. So it's going to be inches short. Oh, what a mark.
They're getting a great mark. Oh, man.
They mark it on the 20. First down, Pittsburgh.
He'll be just inside the 20 on the black line. That angle there, look where he comes down. He's hit here. He's knocked way back.
It's not where he comes in down, Paul. It's where he catches it up in the air. Right here, you can see.
He's not beyond the line. He's behind
that angle,
the line.
It's pretty close.
Pretty close.
But Seward in motion. O'Donnell is sacked by Chad Hennings. Hennings, a two-time GTE Academic All-America from the Air Force Academy, the 288-pound former pilot in the Iowa, population 150. Second down, underneath the Hastings, tackled immediately. Good coverage from Robert Bailey, a former Ram, with the Stewart, the nearest receiver on the right side. O'Donnell has to hurry to the end zone. No, short, but caught. What a catch by Ernie Mills. Mills, who made the brilliant reception at the end of the AFC Championship game against the Colts. And the Steelers spend their final timeout.
Here inside is where people have been coming open most of the day. Ernie Mills cuts inside. What a catch. Going up high, knowing he was going to get hit when the ball was delivered to him.
Scott Case, the defender.
Oh, he gets nailed by Scott Case. But watch this catch. That ball is bobbled in the air, and he still has enough to hold on to the football. They pick up the first down. The only problem is they're running out of time. They only have 17 seconds, and they have no more timeouts.
Ball at the 6-yard line. Well,
everybody knows that if you're going to beat Deion Sanders, you beat him to the inside. You don't try to beat him outside or deep. This is where Neil O'Donnell threw this ball.
That's right. Here, let's look up top. Here's Yancey Thigpen going to run inside. Watch Deion Sanders. He's hoping for some help in the inside, but Neil O'Donnell just throws it before the help can get there.
I mean, that's just a perfect throw. You depend on a guy on the outside, and Neil O'Donnell knows that. And you got to know that you can throw the ball inside on Deion Sanders. That time, Thigpen went in. Sanders couldn't stay with him, and here it is. Watch how quick this ball is delivered inside. Even Deion is sitting inside, and he beats him.
Pittsburgh 7. The Steelers with a 54-yard drive late in the half. O'Donnell hitting Thigpen 6 yards for the touchdown to make it a game. We'll be right back with the Oscar Mayer Super Bowl halftime show starring Diana Ross after these words from your local station.
Tumble along with Mike Ditka, Joe Gibbs, and Joe Montana. We will get Coach Gibbs' halftime adjustments in just a moment. First, let's hear from the two coaches. Will McDonough spoke with Bill Cowher, Jim Gray with Barry Switzer.
Bill, what adjustments are you going to make, and what are you telling the ball club?
Well, you know, we didn't stop them very good on third down on defense. I thought we were a little jittery at first. Very big key was holding the field goals while we kind of got into some sync. I think offensively started getting a little bit of rhythm. You know, what we got to do now is take that second quarter, the first one's behind us, take that momentum and carry it right over to this half. Because the longer this game stays close, I like our chances.
Bill, thanks very much.
Barry, are you concerned that you controlled the game, yet you only lead 13-7?
You know, it's disappointing when you have them third and 20 and third and 14 and second 18. They overcome that in that last 5 minutes of the first half. Our defense has played outstanding. We've had the sacks. Offense has controlled the ball. The only possession that really hurt us is the fourth one. We don't make a first down, allows them to do what they did in the first half.
Field goals instead of touchdowns, though.
Yeah, we slipped, and Emmett's trying to get the first. Well, obviously, we had to kick the field goal the first one, but the second one we're disappointed. Disappointed on the call. I think we got a touchdown on the call.
Barry, thank you. Good luck in the second half.
All right, guys.
both sides exuding confidence as the second half approaches. Got to think the Pittsburgh Steelers are very comfortable in close games. Joe, let's talk adjustments.
Well, I think Pittsburgh started off the game kind of tight. Bill Cowher even said that. And I think the first thing they need to do is, hey, they opened it up more on that last drive. They need to do that. Go with their five receivers in there. Get Cordell Stewart in there. They've been a little too conservative. On defense, I'd start making Emmitt Smith beat them. Hey, listen, they're killing us with the passing game. They're being aggressive on defense, and they're killing them throwing the ball downfield. Take a look at Novacek right here. Five catches for 50 yards. This guy's killing them. I start doubling him and play a little softer, make him beat you. Now, when you start talking about Dallas, on offense, stay with the game plan. Hey, they're reading it great. When they get aggressive, they're throwing the ball downfield. I'd run Emmitt now. Don't forget about Emmitt. And on defense, I'd take away those inside routes. And the way you do that is don't double people, but play inside position. Don't let them have those inside slants. That's the only thing that hurt them in that last drive, really.
All right, Joe. Mike, the Pittsburgh Steelers made some hay when they started with some good field position.
Well, they've got to be elated because the big factor in the game is the number of points scored. They've only given up 13 points, so in the game. The other thing is Dallas is only 2 out of 6 on third down, so they're doing a pretty good job in that area. They got to do a better job on stopping them on first down. That's where they got to get them into longer situations on third down.
Okay, Eagle Eye Joe Montana, what do you see?
The first thing I see is that you got Troy falling down twice, getting up and completing the pass. There's no pressure on him. I think Coach Dickett could complete a pass as much time as he's had. That's the first thing. The second thing, they've led the NFL all year in time and possession. Right now, they're behind in the first half by 5 minutes. They got to get control of the ball.
All right, Joe, we hope another half of terrific football is in score. 13-7 is our score. We take you back to the booth. Dick Enberg, Paul McGuire, and Phil Simms. Gentlemen.
I hope we didn't waste all our energy the way you guys are dancing to Diana Ross, but nevertheless, how about Emmitt Smith? Now, the first 5 times he carried the ball, 37 yards, looked like they couldn't stop him. The last 6 times Emmitt had the ball, 3 total yards.
Well, Dick, what I'm seeing, the defensive line of the Pittsburgh Steelers now is forcing everything inside. The corners are up on the line of scrimmage. If he breaks outside, they're making the tackles. A change in philosophy has worked very well.
And how about passing out of the 5 wide and 4 wide for Pittsburgh?
You know, Phil and I were looking at things, and we talked between plays, and in 5 wide, there's always someone open. In this first half, Neil O'Donnell has been throwing to the wrong man. He has not thrown the ball to the right guy, but when they get to 5 wide, there are other guys for touchdowns. He's picking up, you know, short yardage with him, but I think they're going to adjust. I think they've now calmed down, and now they can play.
System formula cleans your entire fuel system, removing dirt and carbon deposits with 10 times the power of ordinary gas treatments. After all, it's not just how great it looks on the outside, it's how great it runs on the inside. Slick 50 fuel system formula. Don't forget the inside.
Jean-Claude Van Damme, Julia Roberts, Brooke Shields, Chris Isaac, Outbreaks Marcel.
I'm the madness!
It's the 1 hour friends after the Super Bowl. There's drama. Action.
Can you beat up that guy?
And romance.
You're swell.
A Super Friends tonight after the Super Bowl on ABC.
17 warmed up in the second quarter, and he too with a touchdown throw, both from inside the 10-yard line. After losing 2 weeks ago, and he said, now I know how important this game is. Dumps it off to Van Morris, who catches two passes, and he gets in the open field. He's a bowling ball to the 50-yard line.
This is something the Steelers haven't done today.
The first completion to someone other than a wide receiver, Horns. Big hole left side. Look at him run over tacklers. Still on his feet to the 35. Oh, my.
Dale Williams, come to your left here. You're just going to see him coming right there. Look at this. Boom. Dixon Edwards just clear. Darren Smith, he just knocks right out of the hole. And Van Morris, a big man with good feet. Defensive back, do not want to see him get in the secondary.
Darren Woodson going to the Pro Bowl again, finally made the shirt tail tackle. That's a load. We're coming. The quick throw, incomplete to Andre Hastings. And what a hit by Scott Case. Scott Case takes a shot here. He's waiting for Andre Hastings to go across the middle of the field. Second half, leading 13-7. Cowboys have it. Smith brought down in the backfield by Kevin Green and Greg Lloyd. They come over the middle. Michael Irvin breaking tackles to the 35 and a first down. 16 on the play.
Look at him at all times.
Four catches, 59 yards, and Emmett, they try to get him to run outside the Steeler defense, and it results in another negative play for Dallas. 4 yard loss.
LeVon Kirkland, watch this. The guard goes, and he comes right in behind. You're going to see him come in on this play right here. And from behind, he catches Emmett Smith. This guy is 263 pounds and can move.
Reverend Doctor. Second and 14 to the sidelines, and Kevin Williams has the catch at the 38-yard line in front of Willie Williams.
Don't let him beat you.
That ball is short. It bounces to Michael Irvin, and Aikman hit as he throws as Kevin Green was in his chest. And he takes a handoff from O'Donnell. Is he going to throw? He wants to. Nobody open, so he runs it. And out of bounds at the 47. He does have a first down.
And this is what he does for you. They handed the ball. This is supposed to be thrown downfield to Thigpen, I believe. But Cordell, now watch what he does. Watch how quick he makes a decision. Now, get out.
Excellent job by John L. Williams staying with the block and giving him a chance to go down the field. And right there, it's a legal hit in inbound. Scott.
The back joining O'Donnell. Blitz. O'Donnell over the middle. Intercepted wide open is Larry Brown. No one near him, and Brown takes it inside the 20 to the 18.
Well, I'll tell you what, the Steelers do a wonderful job. They pick up the blitz perfectly. Everybody is stopped. Neil O'Donnell has time, and watch what he does. This is there. Larry Brown is on the outside. Watch the receiver come down. He's wide open. Neil O'Donnell stands in there. Look at it. Larry Brown lets him go. And Neil O'Donnell panics in the pocket, thinks he's going to get hit, and that's one of the reasons why the ball gets away from him.
Look at the time he has to throw the ball. He has. And you're talking about the offensive line just did a magnificent job of picking up the blitz, and then O'Donnell throws the ball away.
You can see a turnover the game. The Cowboys at the 18. Aikman looking for the strike early. He finds his man inside the two. Michael Irvin. Darren Perry chased him out at the two.
But Troy Aikman just buys some time right here. Michael Irvin does a good job of just getting outside of Darren Perry, and it's an excellent throw by Troy Aikman on the run.
You know, the one thing about it, the Pittsburgh Steelers in the first half, ball kicked out of bounds, they get it on the 40. They have a chance to do something downfield. They don't do it. Here they have another chance, an opportunity, and the offense twice now has given the ball back to Dallas.
First and goal, Emmett Smith. Second effort. Is he in? No signal yet. They're marking now. Touchdown, Dallas. Emmett. 17 career touchdown, 100 in the regular season, and 17 now postseason play.
All right, here comes Emmitt Smith. Now, this is all power. You're 2 yards out. You've got that big offensive line. Emmitt has stopped here. His continuous effort. Look, he is turned back by Carnell Lake. And then he moves in here. He's down. That is not a touchdown. But tell you right now, the ball doesn't go over the goal line until after, and the whistle should have been blown. Here comes Emmitt Smith now. Watch this here. In that hole is Carnell Lake. Now, look, he turns him sideways. Now, at the end, Emmitt is on the ground, decides to turn the ball into the end zone. That's not a touchdown.
Throws the receiver to Larry Bryan.
And now the penalty on the kickoff return. First down at the 15 for Pittsburgh. 6.5 minutes left in the third quarter. O'Donnell eludes the rest, but then down he goes. A sack at the 10-yard line. Chad. It's the second sack for Chad Hennings in the game. And give it to Morris. Morris fights his way out to the 18-yard line, where it'll be third and long. Leon Lett credited with the tackle. Four wide. Ooh, almost a bad snap again. Andre Hastings dragging backwards and may have gotten the first down with that second effort.
Excellent job by the Cowboys in the philosophy. Blitz him, make him throw to the hot receiver out in the...
And Nickel Bates, they call it, the Cowboys' seven defensive backs. Throw to the sidelines, and nice fingertip catch by Hastings again. Ducks out of bounds at the 35, where it'll be third and short two. In the third quarter, the Dallas Cowboys leading Pittsburgh Steelers 20-7, Super Bowl 30. Third down and short, Cordell Stewart. No, that's Eric Pegram, rather, with the toss. And Pegram, who played at Atlanta and once had a 1,000-yard season. That was 2 years ago. That's a Sanford and Son. O'Donnell. Oh, what a nice catch by Mills. That ball, again, wasn't on target, but Mills went out and got it. Brock Marion, the defender. Interception of Correa. Darren Smith, and Smith rides him down short of the first down. It'll be third and two. No. Morris tries the left side, and he is stuffed. What a hit. Tony Tolbert was in on the tackle. Along.
Defense is solid now.
What do you go for here? The Cowboys take over on downs.
You know, Phil, you made one of the great points just a moment ago. If you're going to run that guy up in there, you better have a lead blocker that can block somebody. When you have only one guy in the backfield and you're going to run the football, they know that he is the only guy that can get the football.
So over on downs, Dallas has it at the 47 of Pittsburgh. And Emmitt Smith breaking tackles. They had him for a loss, and he leaves 5 men in his wake before Greg Lloyd can get him.
You know what amazing on that play? Ray Seals.
Green. Another check in motion. Quick throw to Irvin. Almost intercepted. Greg Lloyd.
Excellent job by Greg Lloyd. He sees the quick drop by Troy Aikman.
As he defended Michael Irvin. So Rod Woodson, many thought he'd never play this year, and he worked and worked after that knee surgery after the first game of the season, and he made one of those typical great corner plays of his.
Well, look at Rod Woodson right here. He single covers on the outside by Michael Irvin. A good plant, and that ball is thrown.
To play tonight, Paul.
The next punter talking
to put the ball out of bounds and give your team a chance.
Final minute of the quarter. With Ernie Mills. Sidelines for a first down across the 30. Good pickup on first down out to the 37-yard line where Shante Carver, who played here with the Sun Devils of Arizona State, makes the tackle. Final seconds of the third. We'll be right back after these messages from your local station.
Imagine a city where in the dead of winter, a summer of dreams echo in the wind.
In the spirit of the Olympics, Atlanta builds towards a dream. The Centennial Olympics in Atlanta. The greatest games for the world to see. This summer on NBC. A Cadillac DeVille. Only been town car. The DeVille has front-wheel drive and full-range traction control standard. And now it's made even better with the North Star system. Just something to think about when you have somewhere to be this winter. Nothing feels like a Cadillac DeVille. Now $469 a month and $2675 down.
So, you think you can pick me up in the morning?
See your Cadillac Tri-Statesman. Sights and sounds of high performance are brought to you by Crystal Clear Amoco Ultimate Premium Gasoline. Formulated without certain harmful impurities, it's the fuel that can motivate some of the world's most renowned performance vehicles. Crystal Clear Amoco Ultimate.
Most of this airline's fleet is modern enough to meet those quieter standards 5 years ahead.
Think we could meet the dog?
Mad About You, next Sunday on NBC. You're watching Super Bowl 30 on NBC.
A short six. The middle, 45 to the 49. Great open field tackle by Scott Case. A gain of 12. Down has not been a good down for the Steelers. They're averaging 2 yards on every first down in this game. Better this time. Is that really a fumble? If it is, it is a Pittsburgh ball at the 35. Still no official signal.
Someone's got to make a call.
Ernie Mills was drilled by Scott Case.
Watch him right here. You see Neil O'Donnell?
Here it is. It's a catch. First down. He did indeed get 1-2 down, and the Steelers avoid another big turnover as the ball is recovered by Mark Bruner, the rookie tight end.
Look at this hit by Scott Case. That is sensational. And then heads-up play by the tight end Bruner. They get the first down at the 35. Here's
complete to Ernie Mills. Oh, was that very nearly intercepted by Larry Brown. Brown was just a short step away from his second pick. Those seven defensive backs on the field for the Cowboys. Spread formation. Here they come. Complete to Thigpen. First down at the 21.
Boy, are they picking up the blitzes. They had a blitz on that again, and this offense is picking up and giving that man time to throw the football.
Forward in motion. Good protection. Now breaks down, and Haley has another sack.
Haley's going to end up with the sack, but number 67, he comes in now. Here comes Haley. Look at it. There he is. Russell Maryland is there. Haley doesn't get really
good. No way. Tony Tolbert was the man who finally wrapped him up. 6 yards for the veteran. Start to hold. Plenty of legs. Johnson connects from 46, Dallas 20, Pittsburgh 10, 11 minutes, 20 seconds to go. Onside kick.
Before the game, and right there, Dixon Edwards was already taken off before the ball was kicked.
The Pittsburgh, that's a 12th onside kick in Super Bowl history, and only the fourth time successfully. Successful is the pass to Hastings, and that first down at the Dallas 41. Off a scoring play, but it didn't have a chance. Pass is high again, and what a kick! for Neil O'Donnell have been brilliant.
Fantastic is the word. Brilliant, Dick, you're right. You see him up in the slot right there. Andre Hastings goes high, catches the ball on the
set. It was, of course, John Solworth, and they're the top two receivers here. Hastings and up Thigpen, and this is Ernie Mills.
Thigpen's hurt. That's Ernie Mills.
You know, there haven't been many passes that have been below the shoulders of his receivers.
No, not many. You're right, Dick. Here's a good look at Larry Brown coming up, making the hit, and he hits him in the back of the head.
And twist that left knee, got twisted underneath. And, of course, an injury to one of the Steelers punishes them in that 4-5 wide. It's trail 20-10. 10 minutes left in the fourth period.
So much for the blowout, boys. Now we get the football game is on.
Morris in motion. Morris had to lose his forward momentum to come back and get the ball, so he didn't have that charge going upfield. Almost perfect the last two drives. Looks to the end zone, throws underneath, complete the thick pin, drilled it down at the five, and hangs on. Dixon Edwards almost dislodged his shoulders from his hips. Edwards is to the 2 yard line. 1 yard rushing to lead all ball carriers. Gets the handoff, breaks the tackle. Touchdown, or is it? They haven't marked it yet. No, they mark it down at the 1 foot line. And then this time marking it.
Paul, when you're a big running back like Bam Morris is, you cannot tackle him high right there. You saw Dixon Edwards get a chance, goes high.
That's a touchdown. The ball had broken the plane of the goal line. Morris.
Man, was that beautiful. Did you see John L. Williams block on the outside? Tell the Pittsburgh Steelers they can't do something, you told the wrong team.
You see how the Pittsburgh Steelers defense has shut down the Dallas offense. Aikman to throw from deep in his own end into Kevin Williams. Ducks under a tackle, and he's all the way to the 34. What a big play for the Cowboys. 22 yards.
You know, Kevin, these big offensive linemen man-to-man, they're using their speed, moving around, and the Cowboys just can't get enough helmet and equipment on them.
6 yards, as you see Irvin McCormick being taken back for some medical attention. Aikman blitz, falls at the 25, the sack by Kirkland, the blow on Kirkland.
Let me say one thing about LeVon Kirkland. When he walked into us the other day, and I said to LeVon, and we always talk about the unsung hero of this defense, they talk.
Williams wants interference as he went down at the 45. No flag. Pittsburgh is held.
He was slipping.
Four linemen and seven defensive backs. Blitz on. O'Donnell.
Intercepted, and Larry Brown has a shot at a touchdown. Brown knocked out of bounds by John L. Williams. And Brown again, not even near the play. The ball thrown right to him.
Looking at you, you're going to see the blitz. The Cowboys pick it up. Neil O'Donnell throws it quick outside. The receiver does not adjust the route. Larry Brown with two interceptions. He just stood there, both of them thrown right at him.
Out of bounds at the 6 yard line. So it wasn't Neil O'Donnell on that play. Emmett Smith lines up deep. Smith inside the 5 to the 4 yard line. Joel Steed, the nose tackle, 300 pounder from Colorado, makes the stop. Second and goal. Touchdown. 2, Emmett Smith, touchdown blast.
On the center and the right guard, watch him here push the Steelers off the line of scrimmage, and then Darryl Johnson does a good job of kicking it out. Emmett Smith gets to the half-yard line, pushes his way into the end zone.
Well, the story after the two interceptions, it took Dallas only two plays to score each time as Larry Brown positioned them deep in Pittsburgh territory with his picks. Well, there's a man who might well get a considerable number of votes for the most valuable player in this game, even though there was nothing spectacular about his interceptions, but he played his position right. You know, O'Donnell out of the shotgun with Hastings in motion to help on a blitz if there is one. Now O'Donnell to Hastings. Breaks out of the tackle. Still on his feet. What an effort by Andre Hastings. Here's he has a first down at the 34. Got in the path. Complete to Yancey Thigpen. No, it's Corey Holiday. He's in because of the injury to Mills. Holiday, free agent pick a year ago out of the University of North Carolina.
Bad kick, so just be patient and make the plays that are given to you.
Second and one for O'Donnell. Lots of time. Leon Lett chases him out. Flags are down in the secondary. And finally, O'Donnell throws it away. Stops the clock with 2:34. Illegal chuck downfield beyond the 5 yards against...
They haven't said yet, but Bailey is the one that went running.
Illegal contact. Number 40 on the defense. 5 yards. First down.
2:34. Left in the game. Underneath to Hastings, his 10th catch of the game. Trying to get out of bounds. Saves some time by ducking out at the 45-yard line of Dallas. You know, look at 234 yards. One touchdown. Two intercepts. Steps up. Dumps it off to Williams. Darnell Williams tackled at the 40-yard line. First down. 2:17, 2:16. Steelers will try to get off a play before the two-minute warning.
The game clock, he might be just looking at the 24-second.
He gets a play off. And goes deep downfield for Stewart. Incomplete, and Dion was there. And the two-minute warning at 1:58. Back after these messages. He is a primetime guy. You know, play a little football. Of course, last 2 years, Major League Baseball with the Atlanta Braves. Then you go to the 49ers and then the Cincinnati Reds, Giants, and then to the Dallas Cowboys.
Well, that's a quick change, artist, you know?
Yeah. Except me, I've never had a vacation. His wife's worried, though, I'd be around the house too much if I didn't play baseball. Second and 10 for O'Donnell. Underneath, incomplete. Williams, third and 10, total against the blitz. And it's 10 to keep this drive going on third down. Oh, almost intercepted as that went through Andre Hastings' hands. Incomplete. That would have been a first down. Now it's fourth and 10, and O'Donnell took a hit as he threw. Switzer to say, hey, it's okay now. This is a new era.
Well, I guess we're told that Larry Brown is the most valuable player, and he's the one that's holding Switzer up, getting ready for the Gatorade.
Yeah.
Larry said, let me get out of here, man.
Larry's got to do a better job of acting. You know, he's got to turn Barry away from those guys so they can get him.
So Larry Brown, a long shot to even make it in this league. Big Scott. There's the other. Last play. O'Donnell heaves it as far as he can. And the Cowboys come down to the interception. And it is Brock Merriam. Final score, Dallas 27, Pittsburgh 17. By the way, Larry Brown will receive received the Pete Rozelle Trophy after the late commissioner who watched the game in Southern California. Said his favorite Super Bowl was the 35-31 Pittsburgh win over Dallas, Super Bowl 13 in terms of the excitement. And this one, it appeared for a while, 5 minutes left in the game, that we might be headed toward a possible overtime until Larry Brown made the second of his interceptions.
It's one of those things. We sat here for 2 weeks and you kept listening to the things where the Pittsburgh...
Did you hear? Seinfeld's coming back for a whole new year.
Well, how do you do?
And this week, it's an all-new Seinfeld with a twist. NBC Thursday.
Of all the car commercials in the world, she had to walk into mine.
It's the Edner Toyota-thon.
Look at those Corolla sales.
Play it again, Ed.
That great Corolla lease deal is backed by popular demand.
Ed, it's that Mr. Toyota-thon.
You're on the air.
Say it like you mean it, lad.
For a low $189 a month, you can't beat value like that.
Better hurry. Toyota-thon ends soon.
Okay, boy. Now, just like I taught you, I want you to open the cooler. I want you to get me an ice-cold Pepsi. Come on, boy. You can do it. Good boy, good boy. Maybe later we'll play Frisbee.
Hey, big boy. You got another one of those for me?
Oh, yeah. I love this dream.
The job needs four guys now, and the guys need all their equipment. You're working harder than ever. You need a truck that does, too. Meet the all-new 1997 Ford F-150, the only full-size pickup with a standard super cab third door, 60-40 split rear bench, and standard dual airbags, plus a taller cab for more hat and boot room than ever. After all, the guys aren't getting any smaller. The new Ford F-150. Strength after strength after strength.
Extreme cold. It can change the state of your motor oil, causing it to flow too slowly, keeping it from reaching vital engine parts in time. Fortunately, there's Quaker State Motor Oil, proven to exceed the highest standards car makers have established for engine protection. Quaker State. What's the state of your motor oil when you're out in the cold? Quaker State exceeds the highest standards for engine protection.
Sunday excitement continues with the Publishers Clearinghouse Prize Patrol. We're live near Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania to surprise someone with $10 million.
Hello. Patricia?
Yeah?
Please come out.
What?
We're from Publishers Clearinghouse. We just won $10 million.
Oh,
come here.
Come on.
Patricia, come on. Patricia. Patricia.
Coming this summer from NBC News and Microsoft, an all-new channel, an all-news network, MSNBC.
In Dallas Cowboys, let's go to Greg Gumbel.
All right, Dick Enberg, thank you very much. Down here on the podium, they're here to celebrate a familiar refrain, that of the Dallas Cowboys as champions of the National Football League. I'm joined by head coach Barry Switzer, Dallas owner Jerry Jones and his wife Jean, and the commissioner of the National Football League, Paul Tagliabue, to make a most important presentation. Paul.
Jerry, Jean, Barry, congratulations to you on a tremendous victory for the Cowboys franchise. You played a very tough opponent today. Together you gave us a terrific Super Bowl game. This is the Cowboys' third victory in four Super Bowls. You become only the second NFL franchise to win the Super Bowl five times. We congratulate you and your extraordinary group of players. Congratulations.
Paul, I want to tell all you Steelers fans, Dan Rooney and his family, Coach Cowher, what a team you have and what a ball game that you gave the National Football League tonight. And I know that everyone in this country recognizing what the Steeler organization is about. But Paul, I've got to say something at this time. As really as accomplished as the talented players that we have on this team, it pales in comparison with how mentally tough and the character that they've had. This ball game represents the kind of season that we've had. It's wonderful just to hold this trophy for you great players, coaching staff, and Barry.
Jerry, let me ask you, this is your, as Commissioner said, third championship in 4 years. Does this one feel any differently? Does it feel any nicer than the other two?
I think it's the game basically says how I feel. The others, we won with a bigger score. This was a struggle throughout the game. Our team played just outstanding as a team and with the character that, as I said, that they've had. This, under the circumstances for me, and I'm a small perspective, is the sweetest.
All right, Jerry. Head coach Barry Switzer, congratulations to you.
Thank you very much.
It has not been the smoothest of seasons. You told us in our pregame show that what other people thought of you, whether you won or lost, is immaterial. Now that you have won this game, do you still feel that way?
Still feel that way. The only things that count is your family. My personal family and this family right here. That's the ones that stuck with me when times are tough. These are the people I want to be with, Dallas Cowboys. I want to say to Jerry Jones something that's very important. He said to me all year, "Are you having a good time now, Jerry?" Well, I want to tell you, we did it our way, baby! We did it! We did it! We did it!
Let's go back upstairs to Dick Enberg.
So Barry Switzer, who was a young coach and recruited Jimmy Johnson and that man Jerry Jones, they celebrate Super Bowl 30, the Dallas Cowboys champions again. We'll be right back with more.
Locker room. Greg Dumble joined by quarterback Troy Aikman. How is it? I'm more out of breath than you are, and you've played a football game. Congratulations to you.
Thank you very much. This is the guys are just now piling into the locker room, and I think it's a feeling more of relief than anything else. You know, we were able to come out and win the ball game, and certainly there were high expectations for this football team, and everybody's very happy, but relieved just the same.
It obviously was not the smoothest of roads getting here, Troy, but why relief?
I don't know. I think maybe just because there's so much expected from this football team over the years. But it wasn't the prettiest game that we've played. Defense stepped up and played hard when they had to and made the key plays. And offensively, we didn't do it particularly well there in the second half. But like I say, a win's a win.
So much for predicted blowouts. But in the first half, you really did have a chance to put this game away, and it didn't happen.
Well, we did, and then we wound up having to settle for some field goals instead of get touchdowns, and then they came right back. And we had more control of the game in the first half than what it appeared on the scoreboard. Second half, then, like I say, we didn't do real well offensively, but our defense stepped up, and this guy over here played well.
Yeah, your thoughts on the Pittsburgh Steelers before we let you get away?
They're an outstanding football team. There's no question, and we knew that coming in. We knew that it was going to be a tough ball game, and that's what it was.
Troy, you're in some pretty rare company now. Terry Bradshaw, Joe Montana, 4-0 in Super Bowls. You step up to 3-0.
Yeah, it was... It's nice to be mentioned along those guys. And like I say, it's a tribute to all these players in here.
Congratulations,
Thank you. Thank you.
Troy Aikman. Joining me up here on the podium is Mr. Charles Haley, whose playing situation was really very much in doubt, I guess, up until just a couple of minutes before game time. How did your back feel out there?
Well, you know, it got a little sore towards the halftime. But when I got out there, you know, just being out there with the guys, man, you know, I didn't feel no pain. The only thing that was bothering me was my conditioning. I just wish to God that I had a little bit more time to condition myself so I could have gave a better showing.
A couple of sacks out there, though. It seems that you picked your spots very well.
Well, you know, I just thank God. This team has gelled together. Some of the guys that I used to get on all the time, Larry Brown and Shante Carver, really proved themselves today. And I think that this team has really grown up a lot.
You claim your fifth Super Bowl ring, and you have also flirted with the idea of possibly calling it quits. Have you played your last professional football game?
You know, what's going to happen is, you know, I'm going to go to Hawaii, hang out a while, then I'm come back, and I got to talk to the doctors. I got to find out exactly what's going to happen if I keep doing it. You know, like I said, it did get a little bit sore. You know, I'm 32 years old. I got to look past and be able to play with my kids and stuff down the road. But this is something I love. If there's a chance of me playing, then I probably will.
Charles, five Super Bowl rings is nothing to sneeze at. Congratulations
to
you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Plenty more coming your way from the Dallas Cowboys locker room. The Cowboys, 27-17 winners over the Pittsburgh Steelers. We'll take a timeout and come right back after this.
Brought to you by the all-new 1997 Ford F-150, built Ford tough.
The Dallas Cowboys are victorious in Super Bowl 30. Welcome back to Tempe, Arizona. I'm now joined by Bill Cowher, the head coach of the Pittsburgh Steelers. Bill, the slow start in the first half, was the emotion of the game, did that have anything to do with the slow start by the Steelers?
Well, that's hard to say, but, you know, obviously my hats go off to Dallas, and they made the plays and we didn't.
You had a chance to steal this game. What was your feeling coming down the stretch before the big interception by Larry Brown?
Well, I felt good about it. We came out of the second half. We put together a little drive. Unfortunately, we couldn't do anything with it. I think we had a big sack there that knocked us back out of field goal. But, you know, the big onside kick gave us some momentum. We went back down and scored and had the big kickoff. You know, obviously they ended up, getting some field position. But, you know, we still had the opportunity. And, you know, hey, my hat's off to our football team. We got here with our four wides with the no hurry. Unfortunately, we fell short today. But I'm proud of this football team.
Bill, do you feel as though you were beaten or that you beat yourself?
Well, I mean, in sports, I mean, there's so many ways if you want to say it, but the bottom line is the Cowboys made plays and we didn't. But I'll say this about our football team. We fought. We weren't intimidated. We came out and, you know, that's the last play typified this season. We're going to go right until the very end. And like I said, I'm proud of our guys. They never went, stayed, died. And, you know, hey, we gave it our best shot today. It wasn't good enough.
Bill, thanks for coming out. It's a difficult time for you. Congratulations on a great season.
Thanks, Jim.
27-17, the Dallas Cowboys over the Pittsburgh Steelers in Super Bowl 30. We are in the Dallas Cowboys locker room. Welcome back, everyone. Greg Gumbel joined by the game MVP, Larry Brown. And you can tell when a guy isn't used to this, because what did you tell me about this trophy?
I said, this thing is getting heavy. It's my third one, but it's still heavy here.
Let's talk about the interceptions. The first one you said was a Neil O'Donnell mistake.
Yeah, the first one, I think he had a bad read, and I was able to go get it and just hang on to it. The second one, they had been running slants on me all day, so I got a good jump on it and made a play on it and was able to go take as far as I could.
You tied for the lead in interceptions with this team this season with six, yet I can't say that you were really the most heralded member of the defensive secondary, but you come up with a big game.
Well, you know, we got so many stars on our team, but, you know, I just wanted to go out today, play hard. I knew I was going to stay away from my boy Deion, so I knew I was going to be the key today. And, when, you know, whenever you give our offense, Michael, Emmett, Troy, those guys a chance, it's over.
Larry, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
I'm going to talk over here with Emmitt Smith's setup man, Larry Brown. He makes two picks. Emmitt Smith scores two touchdowns. This wasn't your best day rushing, though, was it?
No, it doesn't matter. The bottom line is we won the game. That's what it's all about. And I thank everybody here sharing the moment because, I mean, we all want to win. That's the bottom line. No matter if I got 100 yards or 200, the bottom line is we won the game.
Tell me about the Pittsburgh defense and the changes that they made in the second half.
You know, Pittsburgh played a great ball game the whole day. I mean, their defense, you know, I have a lot of respect for them. And, you know, they just start coming at us and it just kept coming. They never quit. They never laid down. And fortunately, we was able to make enough plays to win the game. And, you know, when Larry got that last interception, all we was talking about in the huddle was getting the ball in the end zone. And, you know, all I could do was just lower my head down and get into the end zone and put the thing in the zone.
18 postseason touchdowns, 5 Super Bowl touchdowns, both National Football League records. Congratulations,
Thank
Emmitt.
You, sir.
Michael Irvin, who's crying about the penalty called early in the first half. You told me you've recanted that a little bit.
Well, I knew it was a penalty. You know, people got to understand, my first job is to catch anything Troy throw. Well, if I can't catch it, my second job is to make sure nobody else catch it. And he got an early jump on the ball, and I was just trying to make sure he didn't get the interception.
I know that everybody, or most everyone, was predicting a Dallas blowout, and although I know you guys were confident all week long, did this kind of game surprise you?
No, we expected this type of game. You know, and when you look at Pittsburgh on film, they got a real quick defense, guys that keep coming and playing hard all game long. And we knew that. We talked about going out on the football field. We said, hey, if we got to play 60 minutes, we'll play 60 minutes. And we got to be careful. We may even have to go to 75 minutes. We were prepared for overtime. It's a good thing. We're fortunate we won in regulation.
3 titles in 4 years. Congratulations, Michael.
Well, thank you. And I'm going to tell you something. This thing isn't over yet now. Don't close the book. It's not the last chapter. We still got some chapters to write.
I haven't closed the thing. Thanks okay. very much. And number 21 here, Deion Sanders, who would like to hold the trophy for just a moment before Michael gives it away into the crowd.
You know, I ain't get to hold this last year.
Deion, this is a pretty good legacy for you. You go to San Francisco last year, they win a Super Bowl. You come to Dallas this year, they win a Super Bowl.
I don't think I was the difference, though. I mean, some people may say, but that ain't the difference.
What was the difference?
First of all, I think the Lord had a lot to do with this, and this team is unbelievable. We a hell of a coach in Barry Switzer, and the big three on offense, and the way this defense performed, we can't be faded.
I'd like to know what's in your immediate future. Are you planning to play baseball this season?
I tell you what, I love the fans of Dallas. and the baseball situation's up in the air, but I'm happy with what I'm doing.
All right, Deion, congratulations.
Hey, I want to give a shout out to my mom, my family, my stepfather, Willie. Hey, my boy's back, Rossville, all my homies. What's up, man?
Thanks, Deion. Deion Sanders, we want to remind you, we have a one-hour edition of Friends coming.